Automobilista 2 was first released on the 31st of March in 2020, which was about 1 year ago, as a beta version due to delays because of COVID. It then proceeded to receive weekly updates and finally left its early access date about 3 months later. Over the course of the following year, Reiza obviously toned down the frequency of updates and got rid of the weekly update schedule when the 1.0 version was published, which is more than understandable. Nevertheless, things are still rather active regarding updates, and there was loads of new content, bug fixes, and physics as well as force feedback improvements. So, where exactly does Automobilista 2 currently stand, or rather, how good did it develop in its 12 months lifespan? This is exactly what I'm going to cover in this video. Automobilista 2's positive and negative developments since its 1.0 release. First of all, one has to mention the massive upgrades regarding content, free as well as paid. Alongside some free tracks added in the 1.0 version, like Bathurst for example, Reiza introduced several track packs set to continuously bring up to 5 all new DLC tracks to Automobilista 2 for the cost of 36 euros in total. Of course, these DLCs can also be purchased individually for about 9 euros each. Additionally, there's also a season pass available for 90 euros that includes all DLC track packs as well as some yet to be announced DLC cars. A more detailed overview isn't really possible so far, as a lot of these DLC contents are not yet officially confirmed. For example, if you were to purchase the premium track pack, you'd get access to 5 DLC tracks with all their layouts. However, as of now, there are only 4 of them available, and the last one still has to be officially announced. And the same goes for the season pass. Alongside all of these tracks, some free cars were also added. Most notably, a few GT3 and GT4s, as well as the championship winning McLaren MP412. The GT3 and GT4s all drive and handle different to each other, which is a good thing. But when compared to the pinnacle simulation of those classes, namely Assetto Corsa Competizione, they can't really keep up. But considering ACC is a GT3 and GT4 only sim, this more or less has to be expected, and it would be rather sad if it was the other way around. The McLaren, on the other hand, is also pretty darn enjoyable to drive, as Reiza even went so far as to include its trademark dual braking system, where you have the option to control the left and right brakes independently from each other with 2 different pedals. Of course, there are some added cars that I didn't mention, but going over all of them would get boring at one point, which is why I'm solely listed the ones I found to be the most notable. The last thing that I'd also like to include in this category are custom skins. Yes, they are only minor in comparison to a track or car, but I always enjoyed using real-life liveries, like for example Red Bull's F1 livery, when driving a Formula car, and sometimes even use them for other car classes. Now that AMS2 has been out for a while, the modern community has caught up and created some amazing liveries that can simply be downloaded on sites like Race Department for example, and then easily applied in-game. So yeah, content-wise AMS2 has made a massive leap and by now offers a variety of tracks and cars almost as rich as its indirect predecessor, Project Cars 2. And as I just said, the addition, or rather availability of custom skins is simply marvelous. The force feedback is also an area that underwent many changes, let it be the removal of some settings or the addition of new ones. Now, in all honesty, Automobilista 2 already had a great force feedback in its 1.0 state, but Reiza continued to push for perfection and optimized it further and further, which showed in the update logs, as almost all of them had a section mentioning force feedback changes or tweaks. For me, the greatest new feature allows you to change the overall force feedback strength for each and every car individually in its setup screen before hitting a track. This might not seem as significant at first, but just imagine driving an aerodynamically lesser car and then switching to, let's say, the Formula Ultimate. To get sufficient feedback for the former, you probably want to increase your force feedback strength a bit, but when switching to the latter, it's inevitably going to result in some nasty clipping. In the end, I'd say that Automobilista 2's force feedback is decent, but not quite up to par with the likes of R-Factor 2 or Assetto Corsa. but that's only a generalized statement. There are some cars in Automobilista 2 which have amazing details and depth to them, but also others where the first feedback just gets heavier or lighter without really communicating what's going on with the car. Physics wise, Reiza also introduced some improvements, especially regarding suspensions, as they were pretty broken for some cars at one point. Overall, the cars in Automobilista 2 feel rather bouncy and are also a bit too twitchy for my likings. However, I think, or rather know, due to some testing on my side, that most of the twitchiness can be reduced to a level where you are not completely oversteering in every corner by making a few adjustments to your car's setup. The bounciness on the other side never fully gets eradicated, no matter what you change. To categorize AMS2 in comparison to other sims proved to be quite a challenge, but in the end, I'd say it's a middle ground between Assetto Corsa and Project Cars 2. The fundamental flaws of the Madness engine were mostly fixed, which means the tracks are less slippery and you actually don't have to avoid curbs at all costs. But the previously mentioned snappiness is probably a result of its underlying characteristics. Here, the same as for the force feedback is also applicable. Some cars, like my personal favorite, the Formula 3 ones, are simply a joy to drive and it feels like Reiza absolutely nailed them, where you kind of feel a direct connection to the road and the car just feels right. But also others, where you are instantly inclined to never touch them again. So yeah, as I said, it's a middle ground between Assetto Corsa and Project Cars 2, but rather closer to Assetto Corsa than the other way around. Next, we have the single player and multiplayer grouped together as one for reasons I'm gonna elaborate on later. These two areas were arguably Automobilista 2's weak points in the 1.0 version. The AI was horrendous and outright dangerous to race, and the only real single player campaign was a so-called championship where I had to compete against the AI in a set race calendar in a set car class. And that's it. Of course, there were and still are the modes Test Day, Time Trial and Quick Race, but the year is 2021 and every simulation should feature them by now. The multiplayer side was also severely lacking, but that was more due to the overall low amount of concurrent players for AMS2, which ultimately meant that there were at most two half populated servers at a time. Besides, the netcode seemed to be decent after they fixed some major inconveniences present in the beta phase, but there was no real incentive to join a multiplayer session and prove yourself against other players anyways. However, Reiza initially promised to deliver a multiplayer rating system by the end of 2020. Fast forward 12 months and one of those areas got lots of attention from Reiza and therefore also improved massively, while the other more or less stayed exactly the same. The single player championship was upgraded to allow you to choose from several different race calendars and car classes instead of just one preset. This in itself is already nice, but the mode would probably still be unplayable if not for some massive AI improvements. Gone are the days where they would randomly shoot each other out of a race, or arbitrarily left the racing line, bumping into you and ruining your race. I'm not saying that they are perfect, however. The harder to fix stuff, like for example a slow and jammed first corner, or rather slower corners with several cars around in general, are still present. However, almost all sims suffer from these exact issues and they are a bit more prevalent in some than others. But I'd nevertheless say that the AI in AMS2 has reached a point where they are rather pleasant to race. Now let's move on to the other area that got left behind, the multiplayer. I don't know how you feel about this, but if a company promises that a game is set to release with a certain feature, in this case multiplayer ratings, then at launch day postpones it for 5 more months, and finally, after 4 of these 5 months are over, issues another postponement until somewhere the next year. I straight out feel kinda ripped off. So yeah, the multiplayer basically stayed exactly the same, lots of empty servers and no incentive to race there. When ignoring this for a bit though, one should not forget a certain feature that is set to be released in this year. The ability for users to join any multiplayer server without the requirement of possessing the according DLCs. Say for example, you just bought AMS2 and wanna race against other folks on your favorite track, the Nordschleife. Now, in any other game, you would be required to purchase this very DLC. But once this feature hits the live servers, you can simply join any server without any content requirements. In my opinion, the single player is decent as is, but Reiza urgently should shift their focus on the mentioned multiplayer features, getting rid of premium servers, running DLC contents and therefore making them more accessible, and finally pulling through with implementing a rating system, as this will without a doubt get more people to race online. Moving on to the last category now. Sound and graphics. When Automobilista 2 was first announced and set to run on Project Cars Madness engine, I was excited and worried at the same time. Using this engine meant that the graphics were most likely going to be top-notch, but if the cars sounded the same as in Project Cars 2, it'd have been a disaster. And this is exactly where Reiza excelled at. Not only did they fix some shady physics in the Madness engine, as I mentioned previously, they also brought up the sound several levels, eradicating yet another weak trait of the Madness engine. For the graphics, they also found a clever trade-off. Initially, Project Cars 2 was the most beautiful looking game on the simracing market, but at the same time, it was very demanding for a system to run. For Automobilista 2, the positive still hold true, while the negative was greatly reduced, meaning AMS2 doesn't look as stunning as Project Cars 2, but is still on an Assetto Corsa Competizione kinda level. But the fascinating thing is, you can run it on maxed out settings, and it still isn't as demanding as Project Cars 2 was on medium settings, while also looking amazing. So after going over all those areas and basically re-reviewing the 2021 version of Automobilista 2, it's time for a short conclusion and some final thoughts from my side. Firstly, for me it's clear that Reiza is still heavily invested into the game and continuously release updates, making it progressively better. Yes, there are some things that AMS2 still lacks, especially in the multiplayer department. And I'm also not 100% agreeing on how Reiza shifts their focus and on which aspects. But that's probably content for another video. In its current state, this sim offers amazing singleplayer experiences combined with a decent physics engine, making for an enjoyable time for most cars. So, if you're mostly concerned about racing AI opponents and spending loads of time in the time trial mode, then there's literally no reason to not buy this game. Besides, in my honest opinion, AMS2 offers one of, if not the best modern day simulation and roster of Formula cars on the whole sim racing market. There's nothing beating a race in the Formula 3 cars at Interlagos in this sim. On the other hand, if some of these aspects are true for yourself, but you'd also like to spend some time racing other folks online, then I'd maybe keep my eyes open for another sim, at least until the multiplayer is more populated. Lastly, if you don't care about either the AI and multiplayer, but just want to enjoy some time by yourself in a sim that looks and sounds gorgeous, then this is 100% your type of sim. So yeah, that's it for my re-review of Automobilista 2. If you enjoyed this video or got something useful out of it, you could consider subscribing for my sim racing content. And with that said, I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers!